In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, coming together as God's family, as we celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and shortcomings and ask the Lord for pardon and mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, who through the regenerating power of baptism have been pleased to confer on us heavenly life, grant, we pray, that those you render capable of immortality by justifying them may by your guidance attain the fullness of glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul reached out also Derbe and Lystra, where there was a disciple named Timothy, as the son of a Jewish woman who was a believer, but his father was a Greek. The brothers in Lystra and Iconium spoke highly of him, and Paul wanted him to come along with him. On account of the Jews of that region, Paul had him circumcised, for they all knew that his father was a Greek. As they traveled from city to city, they handed on to the people for observance the decisions reached by the apostles and presbyters in Jerusalem. Day after day, the churches grew stronger in faith and increased in number. They traveled through Phrygian and Galatian territory, because they had been prevented by the Holy Spirit from preaching the message in the province of Asia. When they came to Mysia, they tried to go on into Bithynia, but the Spirit of Jesus did not allow them. So they crossed through Mysia and came down to Troas. During the night, Paul had a vision. a Macedonian, stood before him and implored him with these words, "Come over to Macedonia and help us." When he had seen the vision, we sought passage to Macedonia at once, concluding that God had called us to proclaim the good news to them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful song.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Know that the Lord is God. He made us. His we are, his people, the flock he tends.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
The Lord is good. His kindness endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations.
Let all the earth cry out to God with joy. Please all stand.
If then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If the world hates you, realize that it hated me first. If you belonged to the world would love its own. But because you do not belong to the world, and I have chosen you out of the world hates you. Remember the word I spoke to you. No slave is greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they kept my word, they will also keep yours. And they will do all these things to you on account of my name, because they do not know the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, I hope as I was proclaiming the gospel to you a while ago, the Lord would not sound to all of us alarming, or shall we say, fearful, as he was reminding his disciples and is also reminding us today. Pero sa totoo lamang po, nagpapakatotoo lang naman si Jesus sa atin. And what is he truthful about? That once we get to embrace a particular mission in life, shall we say, a vocation that we all offer to God, we shall face acceptance and hate. We shall also face consolation and even the pains of desolation. We shall also face pains and also the support of people. As what the Lord said, "If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they kept my word, they will also keep your word." And it is likely happening now. Even this faith that we all love and profess is at the brink of people, for people to face, or even for people to turn their back. Siguro po, mag-imbita lang tayo na magsisimba. Mag-imbita lang tayo ng magdadasal buwan ho ng Mayo ngayon. Magro-rosary kada hapon. Well, people will accept. People would not mind either. When we teach others the faith, there will be bashing. There will be comments. But there will also be praises. There will be the support from people telling you, go on and continue with that. Pero, marahil matatanong po ninyo, Father, kung ganito lamang po ang haharapin ng isang alagad ni Jesus sa buhay na ito, why risk at all? Eh, kung aawayin lang naman po ako, bakit pa ako papasok dyan? Kung lagi lang pala akong pagsasabihan, why be a disciple of God? If we will just be hated and loved one day after another, why take on the call to be a disciple? The answer, my dear friends, lies at the very first words of the Lord in today's gospel. The Lord chose us out of the world. Pinili tayo ng Diyos. At hindi lang tayo pinili, because when God chooses, He also blesses. Kakambal ng pagpili ng Diyos ang pagbuhos ng Diyos ng kanyang pagpapala sa kanyang mga pinipili. Kahit naawayin, talikuran, hindi pansinin o kalimutan ng tao o ng mundo yung pinili ng Diyos, may lakas itong tinawag na to galing sa Diyos, at may biyaya siya mula sa Diyos. It is not only for us particularly called to this vocation. All of us, every day, would embrace a particular vocation, a particular mission that sometimes people would hate and people would love. God chose you, and He would bless you to strengthen you. And dear friends, if you are thinking of doing something for God, be it as a church servant, may it also be a simple evangelization tool through the internet for charity, or simply working and being faithful to who you are right now, then by all means, go on. We do not have to worry. We might face those who would hate us. We might face those who would love us as well. But at everyone's heart lies this one great confidence that will push us forward and inspire us as well. And that is the Lord blessing His chosen one. The Lord protecting us, the Lord assisting us, and the Lord Himself supporting us.
Please all stand.
We joyfully praise the Lord who raised His Son from the dead and so assured us of eternal life. Let us ask the Lord's help in times of trial. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our pastors, especially Pope, and our bishops he continued to nourish us with sound teachings. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
To those who are persecuted because of their belief in Jesus Christ, may feel his sustaining power. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may find joy in our faith even when we are faced with trials and distress. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who suffer in this life, especially the sick, may be comforted by contemplating on the eternal life that Jesus offers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may come to the eternal feast in God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord as well all the intentions offered in this Mass. For all of these we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, you have chosen us to share your kingdom forever. Grant us strength to bear our sufferings and hardships in the knowledge that we will be raised through Jesus' saving power. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please all stand.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept in compassion, Lord, we pray, the offerings of your family, that under your protective care, they may never lose what they have received, but attain the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please all kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please all stand.
Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that redeemed by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Sit.